Today we are going to try to remove some distractions in this image using few cloning tricks in the free app Snapseed. If you want to remove any objects in images with Snapseed, the one option we have is the healing tool. It doesn't work always as intended, especially if you apply it on a rough part of the image. For example, if I try to remove this, you can see few white spots appearing, which doesn't look natural. Now I'm gonna try to replicate the clone tool of Photoshop or Lightroom here. Basically what it does is we can take a sample anywhere on the image and apply it on the objects we need to remove. Here I'm gonna try using the double exposure option to do this. I'll try to remove this distraction here. After selecting the double exposure option, I'm gonna add the same image on top of this one. Now we'll drag it just a bit down so that part of the water comes on top of the object. Transparency is at 50% currently. Now we'll increase it to 100% and apply it. Now going to masking by tapping on the stacks icon on the top right, view edits, the double exposure and brush. Here you can see the original image. By tapping on this invert button, the newly added image appears. But I'll go back to the original image and increase the brush value to 100 and zooming in, I'm gonna brush on this object which basically reveals the image which I added. Tap the eye icon to see where I applied the mask. This certainly looks a lot better. I will also try to remove these people little on the top. Next, I'm going to try to remove other distractions, the people here one by one. First, I'm going to save this image. Then again go to double exposure and add the newly saved image. Here we'll try to remove the person on the left. So we'll drag the newly added image to get a good sample of the water on top of the person. Again with masking, brushing on the person carefully after zooming in. I'll repeat the same steps again to remove the other persons. One main thing to note is try getting good samples so that it doesn't look too unnatural. So after another 3 steps of double exposures, this is the result. But still you can see the lighting not matching. In the next step, we'll try to correct it using the selective filters. Applying a couple of filters on these parts and tuning the brightness to make it closely match with the surroundings. Next, to try to give it an evening look, first I'm gonna darken the image using curves. Then with masking, removing the effect to make the parts of the sky brighter. Couple of selective filters to make the bridge and the left part of the sky brighter. Tuning the temperature and tint to give the image some evening colors. Finally, tuning the contrast with the curves tool. Here's the final image after doing some object removals with multiple exposures. Thanks for watching.